So now that we've got all our zones wired in, we were smart enough to previously do these two knockouts at the top right corner of the VISTA 21iP panel. And the reason they have those knockouts is to fit in the antenna for the GSM board. Obviously with our clearance here, we're not gonna be able to have our antenna stick straight up, but we'll be able to run it parallel, be okay. So we've got this little white piece that comes along with the VISTA GSM4G unit, and it just snaps into the top there. It gives us a nice sturdy spot for the antenna. We're gonna take our GSM. It came with these three standoffs. We popped them off the GSM, and we already pushed them right into these three holes. So you got one here, one here, one here. You've got your little connector board that matches up with the back connector, or rather the connector on the back side of the VISTA GSM board, the side that has the SIM card. Every GSM from AlarmNet comes with a SIM card already installed, and all you need to do is go ahead and align the standoffs with the GSM card and, oops, gently. Don't have as much leverage on the ladder as I would like, but press that board on, down on all three standoffs, into the connector, sits in nice. We've got our little antenna coming off of our GSM. There's a washer and a nut here. Take that off, and we feed it up into this little plastic white piece. Put the washer back on, put the nut back on. Screw that down tight. Which gives our GSM module a nice tight connection for antenna. And we've got our nice flat blade antenna here. Again, if we try to run it parallel or vertical, obviously not gonna work. So we're gonna run it off to the side here. We just need to thread it in. Hard to get a grip up here, so I'm just using the antenna to get that connection as tight as we can. And we've now installed our VISTA-GSM4G cellular antenna card. This is a 21iP board. You can see there's an Ethernet jack to run your internet connection. We're gonna have to come back another day to run our Ethernet back to our router. So that's always an issue, is getting an Ethernet cable from your router to your panel on the 21iP board. So we're gonna go ahead and just activate just with the GSM for now. So, we now have our GSM, our panel is all good to go. All we need to do is put the panel door back on, plug in our transformer, plug in our battery. We're gonna go ahead and use the old battery that was with the Destiny. The old installation company had a date on here, so we can see it's fairly fresh, May 2012 of last year. These batteries normally last about 5 years. Panel doesn't come with one. But again, we didn't need it since we had a good one from the old board. So we're good to go here, and come on, follow me. We're gonna go do the keypads now.